Welcome back, guys, to the 18th episode of the Dark Souls tutorial Let's Play. And last episode we cleared the Deacons of the Deep. And then, yeah, basically the Cathedral of the Deep is a dead end at this point. And we're continuing today at the Farron Keep swamp area, which, let me show you, is if you're gonna quick travel to Road of Sacrifice header, you find it, yeah, just the last slot here, the Farron Keep bonfire, which we uncovered. It is at the huge ladder leading down from the Crucifixion Wood place, yeah. And this place is even more annoying than the swamp above. And also, again, a reminder, this is a giant PvP area, basically, for the Farron Watchdogs or something like that, the Covenant, PvP Covenant, which we'll also uncover in here. But yeah, you better play offline if you don't like PvP. Let's jump into it. So there are different ways we can tackle the swamp area. In principle, the giant swamp area ahead is a giant circle with only one exit way. But there are several ways we could progress through this. We have to do multiple runs in order to pick up all items. And I would recommend we'll just start collecting stuff. Yeah, to the right here, there's a purple moss clump. And also the swamp gives you poisoning. So you really gotta be careful, since it's constantly will drain you HP. And let's open the equipment. I bought a bandit knife before, which I would recommend you equip. And also we need to unequip some armor to stay under 70% weight ratio. So I changed the Fallen Knight armor for Sellsport trousers. Yeah. So we are lighter now. And let me show you a trick. This trick is only recommended if you ain't a magic user. So the swamp also slows you down, and in order to prevent that, you can two-hand your dagger, and basically one of the, if you're playing with a controller, one of the triggers gives you quick step, the special ability, which drains mana, but it allows you to traverse the swamp much quicker. All right, let's start the loot hunt and let's pick up this item, Iron Flesh Spell. Yeah, just keep pressing your quick step. I don't mind that my mana is drained. I simply don't care. And re-equip your Claimer or your Fire Longsword. I recommend against the slimes to play with the Fire Longsword. A Ragged Mask, which is the mask of the ninja dude, I think. And let's do it like that. We'll run to the left side first. Do the left route, basically, of the map. That's more Titanite, alright, yeah. Let's see. This bridge leads to nowhere, right? Yeah, exactly. But this should be an Estus shard. Yeah, nice. One more health potion, basically. Just keep running through the snakes. Or, yeah, it's not snakes. Those abominations, basically. Stone Palmer, nice shield. Let's see. What do we have here? Rotten pine resin. And also there's loot here. Titanite shard. Alright, guys. We're at the first island here. And this is where the bonfire was. And we'll go upstairs here. In order to access the next boss, you have to light some fires. And those dudes need to die. And this is one of the three fires we have to light. Oh, we have to extinguish it, right? Or something like that. But let's see. Now the top is burning, I think. Oh no, it's also extinguishing. Right, we have to extinguish three fires, sorry. Well, whatever. And this is the boss gate basically, and the first flame is going on, turning on there magically. All right. Nice cutscene. And if you have traversed the swamp area, sometimes you really don't get lost that easy anymore. These dudes need to die. Rotten Gru sword. So these Gru guys, they all have poisoning as well. Rotten pine resin. And in the back here, there's another stairs leading down. With a middle section there. And yeah, we'll jump into that island and then back up again, which leads to the, I think that's already the third fire, if I remember correctly. Or the second, yeah. And this guy in the middle is very strong. Be careful, he can jump onto your head. And yeah, basically smash the crap out of your head. So let's try him with a claimer. He can nearly one-shot you, this guy. It's really strong. Yeah, that's what I meant. Be careful. Dang it. Yeah, I hate this guy so much. Maybe we should have picked the fire long sword for that. If he's red like that, don't. Yeah, just run. Don't bother with him. Or else he will just destroy you totally. Man, the claymore is too slow for that. Would you please die? Alright. Yeah, I'm not the best at fighting this guy. Let's pick up a Titanite shard here. And yeah, boys. One more item. Titanite shard. Alright, we're at the second island now. Ethereth dead. And we've of course got one more of those annoying dudes. Wreck him. And this should be the second activation place. For the boss arena, yep. Another one of those ovens. Nice. Second flame activated. So the third flame is a little bit more tricky to get to. But first we'll have to uncover the main bonfire. Also, there should be an item behind here somewhere. Oh no. I think the item is only an NG plus one then. Alright. Okay, let's see, but yeah. This is the fairy place and this is the bridge leading to the middle bonfire of this map. Also, we have to play it safe here. Too much grooves at once. And we also gained the spear of this guy. And this one should be easier now. Titanite shard, nice. Let's quickly check. There's no item here. An item behind there? Nope. Alright, let's enter the bonfire here. And bonfire lit. Nice, as always. Sleep at it. And yeah. Let me see, guys. Yeah. At this middle bonfire, what is it called again? Let's quickly look. This is the Keep Ruins. And the Keep Ruin bonfire is just in front of the unlockable door, boss door, here. So once we completed the third fire, we can go back to this bonfire and enter the boss part of the map. But let's first gather all the items of this place. So, there are lots of slimy monsters in here. Let's kill some. And if I remember correctly, there'll be either a bone shard or an Estus shard, which will increase our healing power again. Yeah, a bone shard, nice. We'll have Estus Flask plus 3 then. And yeah, let me think. Yeah, so there's the bonfire. This is the bone shard and this is the boss arena. And from there, we'll traverse a little bit back here. Lots of items in the on the horizon there. Let's get this item, a Titanite shard. But let's go to this ladder. And we have a giant ladder leading very high up in another rune type building. And as you might can see, we're way above the swamp now. This is the Cathedral of the Deep. And that's the Undead Settlement. Yeah, and Let me think. Yeah, we are at the collapsed bridge there of the Undead Settlement, the giant bridge from Roderick Castle. This is basically one pillar of the castle, of the bridge. And also, there should be an entrance here. Yeah. Right beside the ladder here. And we'll uncover another bonfire. Quickly get rid of the poisoning. And there's a giant old wolf or Farron. This is where you get the Farron invasion PvP covenant. Pray to it. And ask to join the covenant. There's no yeah, there you don't get anything negative if you join it, so of course you should grab the covenant item. Also, you can offer Wolf Blood Swordgrass, which is the PvP covenant leveling up in ranks item. And this elevator leads to the bridge way above us. We might tackle it later. But first of all, there's a corpse hanging there with a nice item. And we should definitely grab that. So move around here on the outside and see. Oh, let's first kill the crystal lizard for Twinkling Titanite. Always nice to have. And let's get back to here. So see, if you attack this wall, it's a yeah illusionary wall which leads to this corpse with the Dream Chaser's Ash. And the Dream Chaser's Ash is an important ash because it unlocks Titanite shards, if I remember correctly. So from this on, you can buy unlimited Titanite shard with souls. So all the plus three weapons you ever want are unlockable from now on. And let's get back into the swamps. Dodge the slimes and re-equip your dagger. And we'll have a little bit of a loot run. Also, there's Estus soup here at one of the islands. And we have a sunlight talisman, which is a good face casting talisman. You can also heal up here one time only. And the wolf blood swordgrass, which is one of the PvP covenant items for free. Let's go. And those giant dudes are very strong. Wouldn't recommend tackling him if you can avoid it. Go to this thing here in the corner, and there's the Nameless Knight set, which is very similar to the Fallen Knight. And also, these guys are spread around all over the swamp. These monsters. So be careful. They're strong casters. And we aggroed one of them, apparently. And this is my, I call it the looting run. Since I don't want a bossa with killing every single enemy in here. There should be a cave with this golden scroll, which unlocks nice spells as well. Dang it. And we died. But no worries, we'll get there. We'll get back to the spot. The cave is always a little bit tricky to get the item on this loot run. We'll get back our 4,000 souls. Again, down the ladder. Wait, we gone that way. So this is one of the outer runs at the outer circle of the swarm. There should be lots of enemies. The cave should be around this corner here. And these basilisks, or whatever they're called, they're trying to curse you, and when your curse meter is full, you just instantly die, so avoid that at all cost. Yeah. Keep running. Is there an item in here? Yes, of course there is. Currency item. No need for that really, but okay. And those items up there are only pickable up when you unlock the boss section of the map. Man, could you please just die? Let's kill this guy there. And just for demonstration purposes, on this spot here. Ah, wait, there's another guy coming. Yeah. Also, I might be able to kill this guy first. Dang it, too slow. Yeah, die. Another one of those annoying jumpers. And a homeward bone in here. And let's see. This is the last flame we have to extinguish, or light, however you want to see it. And the boss gate should be open now. And it should also show us the door, yes. And the door is opening. That's one huge door, man. At this point, you could kill the boss if you really want to. But we still have to gather a lot of crap in this area, basically. And also there's an item behind here, a rusted gold coin. And let's quickly go down here. And over there, in the distance, there's the starting bonfire at which we started the episode. Just in case you are wondering, though, this is the other side around, basically. But let's quickly pop an ember, as promised. Since there's an invasion taking place in here, right at this spot there should be an invasion, which also, look at the homeward bone in my inventory. I can't use it. It's darked out or grayed out. That's an indication that you have been invaded. And again, this yellow finger hazel guy, which we fought before, which is a computer invader. And he's a strong spellcaster. The best thing against him is just try to wreck him as fast as possible. Man, I really hate this guy. And also, he's invisible from the distance. And it seems he has unlimited spells. Strong attack from the Claymore are very effective against him. And he's gone. Nice. So, re-equipped your dagger. And continue the loot run with your dagger. Quick step this annoying mud place. Make sure there's no item left in here. Nope, this is fully looted at this point, I think. Alright, boys. We've done our first looting run through the swamp. That's how I like to tackle this place. Just loot run the crap out of it and then be gone. And reset the map. Yeah, that's the first part of this looting of the place here. I will have a little bit of a cut, and next episode we continue here, right here. I hope you liked it so far. I'm Villa Master, bye and out. See you next episode. Bye.